Hi, this is Nick Carrazza of Creative 111, and we're going to talk about automating lower thirds from Photoshop to Premiere Pro. Wait, what? Photoshop? Premiere Pro? Totally, yes. So I do a lot of lower third work specifically inside of Premiere Pro, of course, and After Effects. But every once in a while, Photoshop just has a few features for long-form projects. If you need 100 to 200 lower thirds, great workflow. I can't wait to share it with you. So time to show it to you. I'm heading over to Photoshop, and I have a lower third already prepared. The lower third consists of three pieces of Photoshop text referring to the company that I'm going to replace off for where the person works, the person's occupation, as well as their name. I've got the Creative 111 logo here, as well as a bar background. Now, while After Effects can easily replace text elements and so can Premiere when you feed it a spreadsheet or CSV file, the magic here with Photoshop comes with pixel replacement, or the ability to swap out a logo that you reference inside a CSV with ease. Let's take a look at the document that we're going to use. To do that, I'll head over to my desktop. Inside my prepared folder, I've got the CSV file here. I'll just press the spacebar to preview it temporarily on my Mac, and you can see the same corresponding columns of name, occupation, company for the text fields and the text that I'll want to be placed based on the person that's listed. And then the two fields for the logo slash pixel replacement, which we're going to perform. So swapping out the logo based on the logo's color, and swapping out the background bar based on the color as well. In the same folder that the CSV file exists, we also have the logos. So you can see the various logos here. And then we have the various backgrounds, all being referenced perfectly, showing the uppercase and lowercase, as well as the file extension. Once this is set up, all it's a matter of doing is connecting these various layers with the column information from the spreadsheet. And how you do that is you can select one of these layers and head over to Image. And under Variables, we're going to define them. Company happens to be a text replacement, and we're going to use the company column and reference that. Same thing is true of occupation and name. And where things get interesting are with the logo and graphic elements. The logo, the C1, is going to be replaced with the logo color column or whatever it's referencing, those PNG files. Same is true with the bar or the lower third bar, performing a pixel replacement from the column bars. You can even see the method it's going to be using to fit the graphic that we put inside. Besides defining all these variables, we also have to connect it to data sets. And from this menu, you simply choose to import, select the file specifically that's located on your system, that CSV file that you've set up, and choose to open it inside of Photoshop. Let's use the first column for data set names and replace using data sets. Excellent. You can even see here what's happening in the list of and what specific data set it's referring to, the first name in the column. If you want to see a preview, simply just check this button. I'll move the variables window over to the side. If I click on the next data set, I'll see that that updates accordingly based on the information that is in that CSV file. Choosing to cancel this, we are all good to go to automate the creation of these lower thirds. Go to the file menu, choose export. The trick isn't to export as much as it is to export data sets as files. Let's select a folder to save this to. I've already created one on my desktop called lower third. I'll choose to replace after pressing OK, the files that I've already created and tested before I started to record this tutorial. Look at that lower third folder. This is looking good. We've performed a pixel and a text replacement, something that's just awesome. And imagine you had 100 of these to do. Heading inside of Premiere, I will head over to my assembly workspace, make sure that my project panel is showing, double click, and find that folder where I saved the 5 lower third Photoshop files. Choosing to import and making sure to bring in each of these assets as merged, I have now have a new bin with all of the lower thirds. Notice that in my currently open sequence, I've locked up the V1 track, and on the V2 track, I have a series of markers, which happen to be where I would like the specific lower thirds to start. Let's now choose the order that I'd like to appear in. I'll choose my name first, of course, followed by Claude's, Josie's, Terry's, and Ian's. With the order selected, I'm going to press this little handy button called Automate to Sequence and choose a few options in here. For ordering, I'll base it on the order I just selected things in, placing these lower thirds at those unnumbered markers in the timeline in my currently open sequence, choosing a method of overwrite. Happy with the other settings, I will choose to press OK, and now I have 5 lower thirds in my timeline at the starting position of where the marker is. This even trimmed itself based on the close proximity of the marker just next to it. I could select all of these and then press Command D to add some dissolves to each of these lower thirds. Giving this a full screen playback, we can now see those lower thirds. And of course, they're going to look just so much better over actual interview material. But with that help of Photoshop, we were able to automate 5 lower thirds by simply feeding it a spreadsheet and using variables. For more tips like this, click on that subscribe button on the Creative 111 YouTube channel. I'm Nick, and I'll see you sometime soon.